Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session I'll be going to explain space wave propagation. So basically space wave propagation that happens for high frequency, and in that frequency range that will be greater than 30 megahertz. So space wave propagation that happens at frequency greater than 30 megahertz. So when we talk about space wave propagation, it is happening at frequency greater than 30 megahertz. Now basically at this frequency wavelength will be very short, so signal propagates from transmitter to receiver via straight path. So due to frequency is high, wavelength is very narrow. That results propagation of wave by straight path. So as frequency is very high, wavelength is very narrow, and that is what resulting propagation of EM wave by straight path. So what happens is this signal, which is having frequency greater than 30 megahertz, it can easily penetrate through ionosphere, it can easily penetrate through troposphere, so there will be no reflection and scattering which will happen by those layers. So at these frequencies there is no reflection and scattering will happen by ionosphere and troposphere. So basically space wave propagation that is having two different categories. It has two different categories. One is satellite communication, and second is LOS, line of sight communication. Now in this session I will not be explaining satellite communication, that is one very different subject, so I will not discuss much about satellite communication, but in this session I'll be explaining this line of sight communication in detail. So let us try to understand what is line of sight communication. So when we talk about line of sight communication, then it is happening from transmitter to receiver via straight path. So if I say this is our surface then what happens is when you send signal from transmitting antenna this is transmitting antenna and this is receiving antenna. Then in that case, that signal that will go via straight path. So this is what line of sight communication, where signal is going via straight path. So here signal travels straight from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna. So in line of sight communication, signal travels from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna by straight path. Now I'll explain what will be the maximum range which will be there in between transmitting antenna to receiving antenna. So that will happen in case of till it touches the ground. So ultimately maximum range from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna, that will happen till this LOS signal that will touch the ground. So up to that it is possible. Now here there are few considerations that we have already considered, like there is no obstacles in between transmitting antenna and receiving antenna, then only LOS is possible. The reason is by obstacles signal will not propagate from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna. So I am not considering any building which is there in between. So what we consider is transmitting antenna and receiving antenna both can see each other. So that is what line of sight. Both can easily see each other, that is what line of sight. So now I'll explain range calculation of line of sight communication. So for that, let us consider our surface again. So this is Earth surface. Here I have transmitting antenna and here I have receiving antenna, and by line of sight they are just about to touch the ground. So this is what maximum possible range in between transmitting antenna and receiving antenna. Now here this is center of Earth. Let us say this is point O, that is center of Earth. And distance from this transmitting as well as receiving antenna, that is R from the center of Earth. And here this receiving antenna that is having height HR. Here this transmitting antenna that is having height HT. And this is even having distance R from center of Earth. Now to have a calculation of range, first I'll consider range of transmitting antenna, and similarly we can have range of receiving antenna. So total range will be range of transmitting antenna plus range of receiving antenna. So if I say this is what small r of T means range of transmitting antenna, and this is what small r of R, that is what range of receiving antenna. So by considering this triangle, one can calculate range of transmitting antenna as well as range of receiving antenna. So to have a calculation of range of transmitting antenna, I'll be considering this triangle. So from mentioned triangle, one can say by Pythagoras theorem, diagonal square is equals to both sides square, where this distance with respect to center of Earth is R. So we can say RT square plus capital R square is equals to HT plus R whole square. And now just elaborate it more. So it will be RT square plus capital R square is equals to HT square plus R square plus 2 HT R. Now here this R square will get cancelled. Now here if you see this HT square, that will be negligible with respect to RT square as well as 2 HT R. The reason is this capital R, that is there in terms of kilometer. This range of transmitting antenna, that is even there in terms of kilometer. And this height of transmitting antenna, that will be there in terms of meters. So square of meter and square of kilometer, comparatively, this will, if you see that comparative calculation, then this HT square will be very low compared to RT square as well as 2 HT R. So by neglecting HT square, will be having RT square is equals to 2 HT R. So range of transmitting antenna, that is square root of 2 HT R. And similarly, we can have range of receiving antenna, that is RR is equals to square root of 2 HR R. So total range, so let us say this is equation A and this is equation B. So one can say total range for LOS, that will be, let us say small r, so that is RT plus RR, and that will be square root of 2 HTR plus square root of 2 HRR. So that is how we can identify total range for line of sight communication. So in line of sight communication, signal travels straight from transmitting antenna to receiving antenna. There will be no band in signal. And there are two categories where we can apply space wave propagation. One is satellite communication and one is line of sight communication. Satellite communication is altogether a very different subject where so many things that we can study. So here we are not delivered to discuss satellite communication, but we can apply that to space wave propagation. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can suggest me those videos which is required to complete antenna and wave propagation here. If I have understanding based on your queries, definitely I'll get back to you by placing videos to solve your queries. And to access all those material which I'm teaching here, you can go through my website. Link of my website is attached with the description of this video. So you can go through it. It will be very helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching this video.